So Jesus Christ was a dark-skinned man with nappy hair.
Wow.
Jesus Christ was a black man. That's what we show you. Give me that Daniel 7. Now, what color was God? Because this Jesus, he the son of God. What color was God himself? What color is God?
Black too?
We finna show you. God is black as well. Watch this.
The book of Daniel, chapter 7 and verse 9. I beheld till the thrones were cast down, and the Ancient of Days did sit.
Question. Who is the Ancient of Days?
Lucifer. Mm-mm. No? Not Lucifer?
Nope. The Ancient of Days means older than time.
God.
God. That's what we're talking about, right?
And the Ancient of Days did sit, whose garment was white as snow.
So this is the prophet Daniel. He's seeing God. He said his garment was white as snow, meaning God wears clothes. His clothes was all white. Greek.
And the hair of his head.
And the hair of God's head. And God has hair. The hair of his head. Greek.
Like the pure wool.
Like the what?
Pure wool.
Pure wool. You know what pure wool means?
White.
True, but it's also going into the texture. The texture of wool is nappy, meaning like an afro. He said his hair was like the pure wool, like this image here. That's sheep textured hair. That's pure wool right there. So God, if he got nappy hair, what color is he?
Black.
Black. You ever heard this before? Because we've been taught lies. We've been taught lies in Liberia. And Liberia was colonized by the white man, and they taught us this image right here.
Yeah, that's... always think that they white, right. Not black.
What was your question?
Quick question, I got two questions. One, who is God's parents?
Who is God's parents? He don't have no parents. So he older than time. That's why I say the Ancient of Days. He said, I'm the Alpha and Omega. He don't have no parents.
Okay, second question. You said God is black, right? But if God coming, he don't show himself. He always call me like, something. So
yeah.
How they know?
Say that one more time.
If God's coming, right? For example, God wanna send a message to you. You know, like come like that and come with fire.
That's true. But Christ is gonna come in his physical form. Watch this. Give me that Isaiah 40 physical. He gonna come in his physical form. Now watch this. When he come back this time, he is gonna come with his power and his glory. But he's still gonna come black skin. Because all the angels is black. Matter of fact, you mean Ezekiel 1 real quick. Watch this. The angels black too. Yeah. All of them in their angelic form, they still got black skin. So when Christ returns in his power and in his glory, he's still gonna have black skin. Watch this.
Which one you want? 13?
Yeah, one of them.
The book of Ezekiel, chapter 1 and verse 8. Uh-huh. And they had the hands of a man.
Uh-huh. So this is talking about the angels. The angels in their angelic form and in their power and glory. They got hands of men.
Under their wings of their four sides.
So now the angels also got wings though.
And they four had their faces and their wings. Their wings were joined one to another. They turned not when they went.
Get to the part where I'm talking about blacker than color.
Verse 13. As for the likeness of the living creatures.
So as for the likeness of the angels, right?
Their appearance was like burning coals.
So they said their appearance was like burning coals. You know what burning coals look like? Black.
Yeah.
There you go. So the angels and Christ, because the angels gonna come with them. Says with the thousands and thousands, they all gonna come dark and skin. That's your question. So, now watch this. With that being said, Christ being black, Israelites being black, we also teach them repentance, right? Now, in the Christian church, you go to a church? When you go on Sunday? Watch this. Do they allow you to wear pants? They don't? Why not?
Because it's a church. You're supposed to wear pants.
Now what about everyday life, though?
Sunday is the day you worship God, right? So you don't go into church with.
Well, today actually is the day you're supposed to worship God. Today the Lord
Saturday?
Said.
Saturday?
Huh?
Saturday?
Yes. What God calls Saturday? He calls Saturday the Sabbath day. They call it Saturday. The Lord said the Sabbath day. Remember the seventh day of the week. Sunday, not the seventh day of the week, is the first.
Then why do people always go to church on Sunday?
Good question. We was taught by our slave master, the white man, the ones who enslaved us in Liberia and America. They taught us this white image, and they taught us to go to church on Sunday. What denomination are you? Pentecostal, Baptist? You're Baptist. So Baptist, we read in the Bible, Christ didn't tell his followers to be Baptist. He said, follow me. Baptist, the Baptist denomination was invented by a white man named John Smith. He taught his people and black people this image right here and go to church on Sunday. The Bible says Saturday. Watch this.
What you got? The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 22 and verse 5.
What we're showing you is everything that we was taught today regarding the Bible in the Christian church is lies. Watch this. What you got?
The woman shall not wear that which pertaineth unto a man. Neither shall a man put on a woman's garment, for all that do so are an abomination unto the Lord thy God.
So the Bible says, you pay attention. Mm-hmm. What did you say?
Read that again.
The woman shall not wear that which pertaineth unto a man.
So the Bible is commanded by God that a woman is not supposed to wear men's clothing, that which pertain to men. And it pertains, belong to me. What do women wear today that belong to me?
Pants.
Ah, there you go. But you see, the Bible says not to wear pants. Women, not supposed to wear pants. Read again.
The woman shall not wear.
The woman, you're a woman, right?
Read. Shall not wear that which pertaineth unto a man.
So what did they say?
Was not supposed to wear man's clothes.
There you go. So why you got on pants?
I'm not wearing dress.
Christianity, that's the answer. Because you was lying and talk the Bible and religion by this man right here. The white man. The Bible say the white man, the devil. Diablo. How you say devil in Liberia?
Diablo?
How you say devil in Liberia?
Devil?
Yeah, just devil. That's a devil. Right, the white man, the devil. So the Bible say you're not supposed to wear pants, read.
Neither shall a man put on a woman's garment, for all that do so are an abomination unto the Lord thy God.
So when you got them wrong, the Lord considers you an abomination. And you know when you read in Revelation, no abomination will inherit the kingdom of heaven. You won't get to heaven. You can't get to heaven wearing pants as a woman. A woman's supposed to dress modestly. You also can't get to heaven mimicking white women. This black context, blue context, you got it? Give me that Proverbs 3:31. Because the Lord is the
office. I'm not supposed to wear that.
No, not if you ain't, you wasn't born with that. Because what you're doing is you trying to portray yourself as a white woman. The Lord don't like that. The Lord wants us to advance in our beauty, which he gave us. Nappy hair, black eyes, dark skin. What you're doing is trying to imitate something that you have.
Watch
this. What you got?
Nappy hair, oh no.
The book of Proverbs.
Today we say nappy. That's a derogatory term. In the Bible we say woolly. Woolly textured hair is God like her. We just read that God got woolly hair. So when you let your hair look natural, you can get it braided up and planted up. But when you blind it, you flat iron and stuff like that, the Lord don't like that. Because what you're saying is, the Lord ain't make me pretty enough. I ain't perfect in the eyesight of God. That's what you're saying. Watch this, what you got?
The book of Proverbs, chapter 3 and verse 31. Envy thou not the oppressor.
What does that mean? Who was the black man? Who's the man? Who's the Libyan man oppressor?
Who?
Who oppresses the Libyan man?
Liberia.
The Libyan.
Liberia.
Liberia. Liberia. Yeah, Liberia. Who put the Liberians in slavery?
Joseph Jr. Robinson. Is that his name? Joseph? Our first president.
Nah, not necessarily. The white man. The white man oppresses
that man.
They come in and colonize and take their resources out.
But it was him who saw him to whatever the white man
something. Say it one more time.
It was him who saw the people.
Right, that's true. And that was evil. Right, that was evil. But listen, the point is, our oppressing the white man trying to look like the white woman. You're not supposed to do this. The white woman got blind eyes with the blue eyes and the blind hair. But listen, we're gonna get up out of here. Check out all the information on the flyer. We got a website and stuff on there.